Today I'm using the carbon fiber ukulele from Enya. I'm gonna mention them because they are the sponsor of today's video. But real talk, I only use sponsors that I know you all like. So whenever I've used the uke and nobody bought it or nobody talked about it, I didn't use it again. So I use the ukes that you all like because I know it's a safe recommendation. So let me know where in the world you are watching from and which ukulele you are using. I love hearing about your ukuleles and what your favorite one is. And if you're drinking something, what are you drinking? I'm drinking coffee with milk. I'm not usually a coffee drinker, but I had a headache today. And then I thought, maybe it's the coffee. So my favorite, Enya Nova. Yeah, the Novas are really, really good ukes. So for this song, Sweet Caroline. Okay, question. Have you heard this song before? The Flight Sakura, aww. Have you heard this song before? If you've heard it before, great. If not, I can do a little thing. I feel like this is the anthem for some people. Like, you either know it and you can belt it, that chorus, or you've never heard it. But you've probably heard it at a party. It was my auntie's favorite, bless her heart. Aww, we will dedicate it to your auntie. I don't have a Macaulay uke, but I have used one before. I haven't heard the song in years. Okay, so I'm using the printable from Dr. Uke. He makes amazing printables. I love how he does. They're very simple. They're very printer friendly. So if you don't have it in front of you, it's in the link down below, right? Sayara, is it in the link down below? So it looks something like this. And I believe you have two options. You have the option of reading it with just the chord names if you scroll down, or you can read it with a chord number, like chart. And yay, we have 100 people here. If you're here, would you please hit the like button? That helps the video perform a little better. We just went to a Dueling Pianos performance and I requested Sweet Caroline. I love Dueling Pianos. It's amazing. Okay, thank you, Sayara. Okay, so for this one, you have an intro of the F chord. And you're just on F chord. So let's say that you're performing at a talent show or with people around you. That little intro is a great time for you to talk, exactly what I'm doing here. And I see people are doing the 30-day uke challenge. I changed the link to the printable yesterday because I found out it was expired. Okay, so if you look on the title next to it, it tells you the singing note. And if you just joined, the printable's in the link down below. So play on the second fret of C string. Where. That's gonna be your first note for the word where. Where. Now we're gonna play a B flat chord. Where begin? I can't begin to know it, but then I know the growing strong. So this song sounds great with just down strums, but that's not the only secret. And here's a secret that I only usually share with my Patreon fam, but I'm gonna try it here and you all can tell me if it works. By the way, I teach on Patreon for ukulele and for guitar. We learn on Zoom, so if you wanna join us, please join. Okay, so this song sounds like it's just down strums, right? That's not really what will encompass the real feeling of the song. If you really want to capture the feeling, you're gonna have to do a strum and then relax the hand a little bit. And that's gonna give you that little bump, 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 bump. Because if you listen to the song, it's little notes. Dun, dun, dun. So if you want to do that, you're going to have to press. Thank you. Sayara just shared the Patreon link if you want to join the Patreon fam. These are the kinds of extra little things I teach on Patreon. And it's easier for me to teach these things there because we have our cameras on and I can see you all and you can ask me questions. Okay, so you're going to do little pumps is what I call it. You squeeze, then release. Squeeze with the strum and then release. Squeeze with the strum and then release. So let's do it slower. And the singing note. Where, where, where again? And then someone was commenting on the E flat that you've never seen it, Brittany. Yeah, you've never seen it with a G string not open. So if doing a full E flat like this is too uncomfortable for you, hi Melinda, hi Carmen. Carmen, is Alan with you? If he is, hi Alan. You can open that G string and just do it without it. But then you can't do the mutes the same way because the G string rings. So it's best to do the full E flat because then you can do those pops. Now this is called left hand muting. That little squeeze release is called left hand muting. If it's too challenging for you right now, don't do it. Come back tomorrow, try it again. Come back the next day, try it again. By the fourth or fifth day, you'll have it, okay? So we have those first two chords, B flat, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And hi P and hi Bill. And then E flat, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And back to B flat, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, F chord. Now the F chord mute is fun because you do your F chord and then wah, mute with the ring and pinky. Wah. Okay? Hi, kid who does fun things. Welcome. So let me show you what it sounds like without the singing, just so that you can hear the left hand muting. 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, E flat. Joe! Welcome! F chord. And the next phrase is the same. B flat. Canyon City, Colorado. Awesome. And then F. And here we go to an F7. And then we will have the pre-chorus. The hands, touching hands. Okay, so give me a green emoji in the chat if you are ready, or you can just say ready to do a play through with lyrics. If you're not ready, let me know. Just write the word again, and I can teach exactly what I just taught. I can teach that again. And thank you for the compliment on the ukulele. I love the pepino emoji. That's my favorite. I eat pepinos every day. And Angie, hi. I'm so excited that we get to meet in person this month, and I get to give you your uke. Okay. So let's try it from the verse where it says, Stefan, welcome. 1, 2, with the words ready, go.
Where if I can, I can't begin to know it, but then I know the knowing's wrong.
Keep going, ready, and
wasn't the spring.
Hi, Sarah.
And the spring became the summer. Would I believe you come along?
Okay, so we have that same phrase. B flat, E flat, B flat, F. And then again, B flat, E flat, B flat, F. But, and everything gets 8 beats, right? Except the last F. Can you do the F for 8 beats? Absolutely. You can do that F for 8 beats. And then keep going. So if you're more of a beginner, don't do the F7. The F will work just fine. So now we have the pre-chorus. And the F7 fits nicely because then F7 wants to go to a B-flat. So like you have your F, 2, 3, 4, then the F7. You can do a full F7 or just a half F7. I like the full F7 with a pinky on the third fret of A string. So exactly as it's written there, but add the pinky on. I just love how that high note sounds. So that's another option for the F7, and it makes the muting easier. So you have your F for 4 beats, and then F7. Wow, full F7, I'm learning so much. Yeah, so I'm telling you, this is what I like to do on Patreon because it's just easier to see everyone and then to get nods when everything's working. I always ask like thumbs up, thumbs in the middle, thumbs down. And seeing everyone give me thumbs shows me like I got it, or I need more time, or I did not get it. So It's just so much fun there. Anyway, so we have that F, and then F7, and then we go to the hands section, and then G minor, A beats here, F7, your Highland, E flat,
touching you.
That F7 situation signals an Iowa State Cyclone victory. I love that this is such a celebration song. You know what? We are celebrating. My husband Jaime got a job. So I share little vlogs when big event things are happening in our lives. I share little vlogs or little videos on Patreon. And so I had shared on Patreon that my husband lost his job, and we've talked so much about maybe leaving California just because of the prices of things. And we're also like on the border to Mexico. Like I can see Mexico from my window. So there's this really famous mountain that is on the Mexican side, but it looks like it's in America because it's so close. And Mexicali has really poor air quality. So when the wind blows north, we get that awful air, and I just want good air for my daughter. So anyway, we talked about leaving California, but he found a job here. And we're planning on doing another little update video probably tomorrow once he's had a few days. Popocatépetl. No, not that one. This is El Cerro Cachanilla. And we're going to see you at Yukon. Yay! Okay, so somebody asked about strumming, muting with the right hand. Yasmina. Okay, so you can definitely mute with the right hand. And this is called palm muting, actually. And it's an advanced technique. I haven't mastered it yet, but I can explain the fundamentals. So palm muting, and if one of you knows how to explain it in writing, please do so. So you wanna put, like, let's look at our hands, okay? Let's say that this is kind of like the foot of your hand. You wanna put that where the strings and the saddle kind of meet, so that when you strum, you can strum with it off, but sit them back down, or you can have them on there the whole time. And I don't have to do the muting on the left hand. But mine doesn't sound just good yet because I haven't mastered it. There's some people who are really good. And then the other way that you can do is a open strum with a mute. But that one I'm not as fast at. So you do have options though. Work with the one that works best for your hand. Effort and prayers work. Effort and prayers definitely do work, because not only that, but I got invited to play with the worship team at my church, because the original worship team that was supposed to play, people had gotten sick or something like that. So they've pulled a few of the musicians from the congregation to do like another worship team. And I felt so like happy to be invited to play with the musicians, even if it was just at once. Like, it was so cool. And none of them had played with a ukulele in a band before. So after the practice, they were really excited to have a ukulele in the group. They said it sounded so good. They were impressed. They were also impressed that it has like a plug-in that you can make it electric. So they were impressed about that. They were like wowed by how beautiful the instrument is. So it was really cool to show a lot of people that the ukulele isn't just like a kumbaya, you know, a tiny little soprano that you have to play wearing a Hawaiian shirt. Is it that? Yes, it is. And it's much more, right? It's more than that. So it was really awesome to be like an advocate for ukulele. Can you show how to strum with fingers? Because I suck at fingers because I only pick. Oh, yeah, of course. So I like to strum. Let me mark my finger. I like to strum with this part of my nail. Let me mark it this way so I can see. And you'll see that my nail is actually crooked from where I've strummed. So, I don't know if you can see that it's more bent on that side. Let me get my this Amazon gift card that I never use. So, I don't know if you can tell, it's a little bit more curved on this side from strumming so much. And I hold my hand kind of like just if you hold like a credit card and then release. And or almost like a Korean heart, almost Korean heart. Actually, Korean heart might work. And I don't mean like the Korean heart I'm saying, because sometimes you'll see people will post for photos doing this and this is supposed to look like a little heart. Okay, so you can do your little Korean heart and then just let the hand fall down the strings. It's good to strum right here where the body and the fingerboard meet, because if you have a typical sound hole, you might get stuck. And then Melinda, was it Melinda who, oh, sorry, who asked, that sorry sounded very Canadian. Which juke did you take? I took this one. I took my Anue Anue African Mahogany juke. I would have taken my signature one, but I lent it to Quincy's girlfriend, Sarah, so she could learn how to play ukulele. Because I'm like, this one sounds really good. She comes from a family of musicians and she's a really good singer, but she'd never played an instrument before, so I thought ukulele's good. So I took this one and we have the plug-in. And if you ever get invited to play with musicians and you need to plug in, a good little rule to do is whenever you have your controls, like I have the mic and volume, always put them at the middle. So don't max them out or don't make them too soft. Actually, you could even put them on the little bit on the soft side, but I just put them middle. And that's really a great place to put your controls, like your volume levels, because then the sound person can make adjustments and then they can ask you, hey, can you come up a little bit? You can do it yourself. Or can you come down a little bit? You can do it yourself. And so yeah, that's a good little technique. I can't remember where I learned it, but I learned it somewhere, maybe from Timmy. Timmy's like an amazing performer and he teaches me a lot. Okay, so let's try verse and the pre-chorus. Verse and pre-chorus. So that's the hands touching hands section. Okay, here we go from the verse. Singing out. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, hey, ready, go.
Ready, go. I can't begin to know it. And I know the growing storm.
1, 2, B flat, go.
Was in the spring, and then the spring September. Who'd have believed you'd come along?
F7,
dance.
G minor. An island strum on the chorus, down, down, up, up, down, up.
Sweet girl, sweet girl.
I don't know if I'm liking that B flat to E flat section. Hold on, the cat. Oh, do you see your cat? Oh, there she is. And thank you, gamer, for the compliment. Hannah! Are you the Hannah that used to come here a long time ago, or are you a new Hannah? I feel like there was a Hannah that like watched for years. Which amp do you recommend for home practice? So sometimes when you go on shopgoodwill.com, you can see the like amps are for sale, and sometimes you can see some really nice ones. I'm blanking out on maybe Marshall was a nice one. Fishman is one word, is a nice one. And then the one I have, this is the Crush 12. This is the Crush 12 Orange. And I'm going to be completely honest and say that 80% of my choice is because it was orange, like bright orange and vintage looking. But the other 20% of my choice in choosing this one is because I know that like my really, really good musician friends love orange amps. This one at the time when I bought it was $99. So kind of expensive, kind of not. Like it's the price of a uke, but for a really nice amp, I'm not mad about it. Do you know what I mean? So, and then you have your controls up there. You can plug in headphones and then you plug in your instrument and then the power cable plugs in right here and then you have your power on off. And it's really beautiful and it's like this cool orange color, which is just so fun because most amps are like black or gray. And I don't know, I like color. I really like color. So that was a big choice, but I knew that it was a good amp, so it's not like if I knew it was a bad amp, I wouldn't have gotten an orange amp. It was just that I knew it was good. When I got my uke, it was $52 and it was really good. Yeah, you can find amazing ukes now for a really affordable price. Like this one is a Enya EUS 25D and I think it's around that price. And it's a mahogany ukulele and it's amazing and it comes with strap buttons. So it's great now that there's so many ukes in the market that things are competitive. But yeah, that's the amp that I use when I practice with the guys too. I really love it. And I need it because we, you know, we have the drum set and the sax, and so that overpowers the uke. Hold on. So when I first announced these, they sold out, and then I got a few more and they sold out again. So if you want to get your clamp, please get it now before they sell out again, because then I have to wait like 2 weeks for my distributor to get them to me. So if you don't know what this is a musician's tripod. And basically what it does is it has this holder where you can put your phone, and you can put it this way or you can put it on the back, and then you can record yourself horizontally or vertically. And or you can record a lesson that you're watching, you can have it facing outward. Or if you have like sheet music and you want to put it on the uke, like you want to read the music, or you're watching a tutorial like this one and you want to have your phone on the uke, you can have it that way. So they're on my Etsy shop. The Etsy shop is called Ukelandia. So I have like, I had 30 yesterday, but 4 more sold. So I have like 26 maybe around there. So yes, if you're interested, get it ASAP. All right, let's try the chorus. I still have the Wolf ukulele. It was made by that company that went out of business. So let me know if you ever decide to sell it. I do have it. I have it. And it's so crazy they went out of business because they were just weeks away from releasing another batch of these and then they never did. This is the Wolf ukulele from Yuka Global. It's really out of tune. Actually, Tana, I was not thinking of selling it because it's so gorgeous and it's and it, like they just went out of business, but for you I would sell it. So send me a DM, and here's why: because I'm not using it and I feel like ukuleles need to be used, you know. I thought I was going to use it more than I am using it now, but the reason I'm not using it is because it's not acoustic electric. And right now I'm recording a lot. So send me a DM. I'm struggling with the B flat switch to E flat. Okay, so that switch is really challenging. The index finger is already where it needs to be. So you can actually leave it holding those two strings. So if you're doing B flat this way and you add the middle ring and pinky, you can like, she goes into her closet and pulls out her uke like she has infinite. I do. That's where the special ukes are, like the Elise Eklund one and the Cynthia Lynn one and so the Wolf one. That's where the special ukes are. I try to keep them in a safe, dark, cool place. Okay, so we have
Sweet Clair.
Let's talk about the chorus. You have
sweet girl, one, two, three, four, two, two, three.
So you have the strumming pattern down, down, up, up, down, up, one time on B flat and three times on E flat. So let's try it. Just B flat and E flat. One, two, a one, two, ready, go,
sweet. Sweet Caroline, ta ta ta.
That's basically an echo of what you just said. So it's
Sweet Caroline, Caroline.
Right? The horns are doing an echo. Same thing with the next line.
I've been inclined, been inclined.
So I like to think about it that way. I used to play sax, and so as a sax player, you have to know like what are you filling in with the horns and what does it mean musically? And so here, musically, it's an echo of the chorus Caroline. The da-da-da is the brass instrument. Exactly, exactly. I think I hear like trumpets, maybe a sax in there, maybe a trombone. So let's try that chorus again. One, two, a one, two, you got this. Which is just a bar. Okay. So that's that weird transition, but it's all just single strums. So if you can do F, E flat, D minor, C minor. So you have your F, and then when you've done your E flat, your middle and ring stay in the same spot, are in the same string, they just move up a fret. And then the index finger adjusts. And then the index finger lays down and you use that on the third fret. So it's F, and you can take your time here. And then.
Look at the night. And it don't seem so lonely. We fill it up with only two.
Okay, so let's play the whole first page. I think we can do it. From the top, not the intro, just where it began.
Where it began.
One, two, a one, two from the top. Go.
Where it began.
E flat.
I can't begin to know.
And B flat.
But then I know the growing
F good. Next line, ready, go.
Was it the spring?
B flat.
And spring became the summer.
B flat.
Would I believe you'd come along?
F7. ready, go. Dance. F go. Dance. E flat go.
Touching me, touching you.
F7. And then back to a verse feeling situation with a B flat. 1, 2, ready, go.
Look at the night, and it don't seem so lonely. We fill it up with only two.
Same thing, next line, go. And then you do a chorus. Okay, so that little section that I'm doing them. Think about it as triplets. So 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So 4 times of that. Or you can think of Saturday 4 times. Anyone screaming so good? Okay.
Sweet Caroline, da, da, da. Good times never seem so good.
On the F7. And then add a B flat. And you end on that B flat. Could you review the tip for transitioning from B flat to E flat? Yes, of course, Sean. So B flat to E flat is not easy. We know that, right? It makes me want to do Elvis legs. So I have my index finger stay in the same place. I just kind of wiggle it back a little bit. And then I add my fingers one back to another. But it's just a matter, I think, of switching that middle finger to the G string, and then everything else just follows. So you go from B flat, switch that middle finger to the G string third fret, and the rest fingers just kind of adjust. Yes. So yeah, on that F7, I'm doing a Saturday, 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 Saturday. And that sets you up for the easier mutable F is 5-5-5-3. And Stefan, if you're doing that F, then 5-5-5-6 is the F7. I'm looking at the cap. She's so used to music, this one, that it's just like ukulele doesn't faze her. She doesn't love the drums.
She gets a little scared. Kika. Hey, mommy, can you come say hi? Yes, you can come say hi.
Come say hi to everyone.
They look at you. They're saying, who's that cute kitty over there? Ben.
She's like, okay, oh, pet me over here.
Ben, mommy.
Ben.
Come here, moms. Come say hi. Come say hi.
Yes, there's the kitty content right there.
Oh.
She's purring. Oh, she's barking at the TV. I'm sorry. She has a cute little voice. And she has a white little chin. I love that little white chin. Oh, yeah, I'm sorry. I squeezed too much. I'm sorry. Forgive me.
Here, let me put the clear chair here because you really like this one. She really likes the curvature of this chair. Let's see if she'll stay there.
Yeah, hi. So there was a king snake in our backyard and she was so scared. She was so cautious around it. Yeah, I think she's gonna settle in there. She even barks at cartoon cats. Wow, that's so funny. How's Sakura doing? She's good. She's wild. I heard it's just the terrible twos that like the labs are just so active and crazy. But she's very sweet. She's a very sweet dog. And Sakura has like 2,400 followers on Instagram. Her reels, one of them reached 1 million and another reel reached 4 million. So my dog has more views on Instagram than I do. My name is Jeff. Hi, Jeff. Kit Kat wants to do a sing along. Kit Kat is very polite in that she responds when people talk to her. Hi. And when I take her to the vet, she talks back. So like, how are you today? It's really cute. Vets get a kick out of it, of how she like, oh yes, okay. How she chats back. She's very friendly. I have a pig, 3 dogs and 4 cats. Wow, you have a pig? I've heard pigs are really smart. Yeah, she's just really friendly, really sweet. She doesn't bite. Ever. Like, if I touch her belly, which, you know, like, some cats don't like the belly touch. Look, I'm touching the belly right now. She just, like, wiggles out of it. But she doesn't bite. And cats really don't like, their paws being touched, you know? But she just moves it. And or the tail. But she just moves. Like, she's like, I don't like that. I like this. Which has been great. She feels like, ee-ee! It's been great for having her around Daniela because Daniela doesn't know soft. Well, now she does, but she didn't know soft when she was first like chasing Kit Kat around. And Kit Kat's been very patient. And now it's paying off because now Daniela understands soft and gentle. So Kit Kat gets lots of love from the toddler. And the other kitty hasn't built that patience with a kid yet, so she doesn't get the sweet pets. I love this lesson. I'm glad, Dawn. I'm really glad. And I'm happy to see you here. My neighbor has bought a horse, a black Frisian. The fertilizer for my vegetables is secured. That's a good way to look at it. Okay, let's do a little playthrough of this. That little intro, it's on C string. Open 2 3, open 2 3, 3 2 0. Da 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 da. I think the next one is on the 3rd fret. get the second one right. You can do it all on C string. It would be open two, three, three, two, oh, and then three, five, seven. And then seven, eight, seven, something. Seven, nine, ten. And that would be your intro seven bars section. One, two, ready, and. I've just started learning how to pick. Okay, if it's out of your skill level, give me those Fs. Okay, here we go. One, two, ready, and. And then that would be 3-5-7. And 7-5-3. And then, what did I say? 7-9-10. And then you start on the verse. So let's try the verse. One, two, one, two, ready, go.
Where to begin?
E flat.
I can't begin to know it, but then I know they're growing strong. Wasn't the spring, and spring became the summer. I believed you'd come along. Hands touching hands, reaching out, touching me, touching you.
F7. Then we go to another verse. One, two, ready, go.
Look at the night.
E flat.
And it don't look so lonely. We'll fill it up with only two.
You can do the triplets here.
And when I hurt.
E flat.
Hurting runs off my shoulder. How can I hurt? Holding you.
F7. G minor.
Touch you
up. F chord.
Reaching out.
E flat.
Touching me. Touching you.
I'm gonna go down an octave. Again, that little picking. Oh, two, three for the first bit. Three, five, seven for the next bit. And seven, nine, ten for the last bit. a good way to remember it is that your last note is your first note for the next bit. So you do 0 2 3 0 2 3 3 2 0, and you know how you played, that was your highest note, that 3? Well, that's going to be your first note for the next bit. 3 5 7 3 5 7 7 5 3. Well, you played that 7, so that's going to be your first note for the next bit. 7 9 10. And then so now let's say that this key signature was not the most comfortable for you. Oh, and Jeff, you were asking about upstrum properly. So I like to strum up. It happens sometimes with the nail. Most of the times it's with the finger on this part. You see where the marker is? It looks a little bit more red. It's right there. So I strum downwards here and strum up there. But some people strum up with a thumb. So find something that's comfortable for your hand. Do it slow first. Like super slow, like down, up, like do it that slow, and then build up speed, and in like 5 days you'll be like an upstrum genius. So see, mine is sideways. Sorry I hadn't answered that. I did see it, and then I was focused on the song, but I'm glad you asked again, thank you. And then somebody else made another. Can someone quicker than me, Shelly, put it in the chat? Oh, okay, so the picking. 0 2 3 0 2 3 3 2 0. That's the first part. 3 5 7 3 5 7 7 5 3 3 5 7 3 5 7 7 5 3. And then the next part is 7 9 10 7 9 10 7 9 10 10 7 9. And yes, about the capo, I want to pull mine out. Let me move this. Sorry, Angie, I went into a daydream. Is Ayara here or Drisha? They probably caught it. Those two are quick. Let me lower this so you all can see Kit Kat. Kit Kat is the sweetest, sweetest. Okay, so let's say that like that didn't really match your vocal range. It's either too high or too low. So yes, exactly, David. So you know how on the where it says the title, Sweet Caroline, next to it, you have... The second fret of C string is your singing note. Well, when you add a capo, let's say we just add it on the second fret to really feel the difference. Then go to the second fret there. Or so if you're a lower range. The low soul voice. Now let's try drinking zero sugar Powerade in North Carolina. Nice. I've tried going zero sugar and man, I get cranky. I'm gonna go to the fourth fret, and then second fret is my singing note. Or so that's a way to explore the vocal range. Now here's another one that I never really talk about because I'm always afraid that a beginner is going to try it and then pop a string and then get mad at me, but I will share it here. You can tune your ukulele down or loosen the strings. So let's say that you do like F, D, is it? No, F, B, D, G. Tune your strings lower, then you can try that and try playing all the chords the same way that we learned them today. And that'll give you a different option. So play around with your instrument, explore different tunings. Be careful, like feel the strings and make sure that they don't feel too tight, you know? But definitely explore different tunings. Okay, so as usual, what I like doing is I like going on Instagram and playing the song there too. FB flat DG. Thank you. B flat. FB flat DG is the correct tuning if you want to drop it down a few steps. So you would have to loosen the strings. But I want to go on Instagram and do a little quick play along of this. If you want to join me, come join me. My Instagram handle is Plazi, P-L-A-Z-I. That's because my maiden last name is Plazola. But I changed it to Mata last week to match my daughter and my husband. How loose is your goose? Yeah, this is my ukulele goose, and I like to loosen her up. I started my ukulele journey with the 30-day uke challenge back in lockdown, and I've been playing since, and I absolutely love it. Oh, yeah. Actually, let's head over to Instagram. I have a question about the 30-day uke challenge that I want your opinion on. And I want your honest, honest opinion. So let's head over to Instagram right now. I'm just going to flip the phone and start over there, okay? See you.